Hello, I am Anthony and I am a design and marketing specialist.
Hi, my name is Matt and I am a design and marketing specialist.
I'm Frank Kuko, I'm the CEO and founder of Impact Networking.
Today, everyone, we are here to discuss marketing pain points and growing a company from zero to 750 employees across five different states. And what were those marketing pain points for Impact when starting out and to get us here to today?
So when building out this new company, obviously you have to make a name for yourself, build that brand. What were some of your goals around marketing and branding specifically?
So at the very beginning, our marketing strategy was to get name recognition. So our marketing for at least the first 15 years was solely standard signage marketing so that we had name recognition throughout Chicagoland, so that when our salespeople went into accounts, the customer had seen the Impact logo somewhere, and it made that more of a soft call than a cold call.
Knowing that Impact has been around for almost 22 years now, you know, in 2008, were there any discussions in 2008 of whether to invest into marketing or hold on to those dollars so that we could stay afloat, let's say?
Yeah, that's actually a good question, and it's a funny question, because in 2008, everybody knows what was happening. It was in the midst of the recession, and things were really tough and tight. But our claim to fame from that period was that I went to other partners of the company, and I wanted to do a program with the Blackhawks. And I thought if we got our name on the board with the Blackhawks, that would give us great recognition, especially with a lot of C-level people who go to those games. And the reality was we almost got in a fist fight with my partners because they wanted nothing to do with that. And I went ahead and signed a multi-million dollar contract anyway against, you know, what their wishes were.
Oh, wow.
And it ended up working and got Impact on the map. That really was the acceleration of Impact, was doing that marketing deal in the middle of a recession when other people weren't advertising, and we were really front and center at that point. And another thing that advertising gave us was the advertisers who were advertising was all big, huge companies. So it made Impact look way more robust than it was for a small, you know, $20 million company at that time.
Yeah, and I'm glad that you mentioned that, because obviously a lot of the clients that we serve are in that small business space. So when we were, you know, 10, 20, 50 employees on the smaller end, what were some of those challenges that we had on the marketing side? And really, how has that transitioned in the last 20 years?
For us, because we're a sales engine, you know, it's all about helping salespeople through marketing. And I think that's an evolution as time goes on. So at the beginning, it was all about name recognition. So salespeople were known. The company was known, and they could relate that to the customer. But as we move forward, then it was about other types of marketing besides standard, you know, name recognition marketing. And even to today now, we're becoming much more sophisticated with SEO marketing and other things. Most of that marketing in the past was name recognition marketing. Well, in Chicago especially, out of the five states we're in, we have excellent name recognition. Everyone's seen that logo. So we're evolving now over to SEO marketing and those millions of dollars that we spend every year to have signs on the tollway and signs at the Hawks. They're being moved into digital marketing now, which we think is going to be much more effective for the company now that we have name recognition, and we'll be able to strategically go after accounts that we feel we would have a great partnership with.
I really appreciate the time today, Frank. I think this was fantastic. I got a lot out of this. Hopefully you did as well.
Yeah.
I'm sure you did. But thank you so much.
Yeah,
hopefully
you.
We were able to address some of the marketing pain points that all of you have and why Impact has grown from, you know, two employees to 750 across several different states. Really appreciate it.